Hello guys, welcome back with me, Dojo25. Today I'm using W-Okada again. Junk SWAT weed. Noise up too, I have really bad mic with free and worse noise. So I use Subtube and Harvest for a gritna. And then Charles want to leave and not see you, Meister Extra CPU, with my D-Force RTX 4060 Ti, with 16 gigs RAM, VRAM that is. I wait to try to read this, and see the result. So, courtesy name Mandy was a Chinese demon, warlord and poet who rose a power to a DN of Eastern Han Dynasty. And become the effective head of the Han central government, during it period, he laid the foundation for what was to become the state of Chao Wei, as a base based on ex-successors choppy, who ended the Eastern Han dynasty and inaugurated the Three King of Barriers. Beginning in his own lifetime a corpus of latent evil around Cao Cao which built upon his talent, his cruelty, and his perceived eccentricities. Okay, let's now try.
Cao began his career as an official under the Han government and held various appointments, including that of district security chief in the capital and the chancellor of principality. He rose to prominence in the 119th, during which he recruited his own followers, formed his own army and set up a base in Yan Province, covering part of present-day Henan and Sundome. In 196, he received Emperor Xian's, the figurehead Han sovereigns who famously held host in Smeana Warlord, such as Nongzhou, Li Zhu, and Guoxi. After established the new imperial capital in Suzhong, Emperor Xian's and his central government came under his direct control, but he still paid nominal allegiance to the emperor. Throughout the 190s, Cao actively waged war in central China against rival warlords such as Lu Bo, Yuan Su, and Zhang Xiu, eliminating all of them. Following his triumph over the warlord Yuan Su at the Battle of Guandu in 200, Cao Cao lost a series of campaigns against Yuan Su's son and allies over the following 7 years, defeated them and unified much of northern China under his control. In 208, Sun Liang and Persian appointed him as imperial chancellor. He embarked on an expedition to get a foothold in southern China, but was defeated by the allied forces in a warlord of the warlord Sun Quan Yu Ben Yui Qi at the decisive battle of Red Cliff. Okay.
Voice. Clown. With a little chillin', I guess. No, faster. He subsequently attempted over the following year to annex the land south of the Yangtze River, never proved successful. In 211, he defeated a coalition of Western warlords led by Ma Chao and Han Sui at the Battle of Donkas. 5 years later, he seized Hanzhong from the warlord Zhanggu, but lost it to Liu Bei by 219. In the meantime, he also received many honors from Emperor Xian. In 213, he was created Duke of Wei and granted a fief covering part of present-day Hebei and Henan. In 216, he was elevated to the status of vassal king under the title King of Wei and awarded numerous ceremonial privilege, of which some used to be reserved exclusively for emperor. Cao Cao died in Luoyang in March 2220 and was succeeded by his son Cao Pi, who accepted the abdication of Emperor Xian in November 220 and established the state of Chao Wei to replace the Eastern Han Dynasty, and even commonly seen as an usurpation. This marked the transition from the Eastern Han Dynasty to the Sixth Dynasty's period. After taking the throne, Cao Pi granted his father the famous title Emperor Wu, or Martial Emperor, and a temple named Taizu, or Grand Ancestor. Okay, let's try.
I don't know. So I'm not listening to my voice, so I don't know what the result is. Apart from being lauded as a brilliant political and military leader, Soso is celebrated for his poems, which were characteristic of the Jian style of Chinese poetry. Opinion of him have remained a vibe from as early as the Jin Dynasty, the period immediate after the Three Kingdoms era to the present. Zhou Sao will praise him for his achievement in Puti and his career, but there are also others who condemn him for his cruelty, cunning, and allegedly traitorous way. In traditional Chinese culture, Sao Sao is stereotypically portrayed as a sly, power-hungry, and treacherous tyrant who served as a nemesis to Liu Bei, often depicted in contraposition as a hero trying to revive the declining Han Dynasty. During the Ming Dynasty, when Luo Guangzhou wrote the epic novel Romance of the Three Kingdoms, which dramatized the historical event before and during the Three Kingdoms period, he not only cast Cao Cao as a primary antagonist in the story, but also introduced, fictionalized, and exaggerated certain events to enhance Cao Cao's villainous image. Okay, that's the result of this, you know, with one twin chunk. I don't even hear it yet, so let's see the result. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment, and see you in the next episode.